Yeah, oh, I definitely think this entire affair is journalistic malpractice. I mean, it's easy to say people have lied. What are they covering up? And it's easy to say 37 indictments. But we need to ask, what were those lies for? And what do those indictments actually say? In the case of the lies, yeah, some people lied in the process of being questioned by investigators. It's easy to catch somebody in a perjury trap. In the case of George Papadopoulos, who actually incited this whole probe to begin with, he lied to cover up his conversations with a professor who claimed to have knowledge of the Russians having compromising dirt on Hillary Clinton. But that turned out to lead nowhere because the FBI interviewed that professor, this guy Joseph Mifsud, in February 2017. He was not arrested then, and he has not been indicted since, including at Mueller's deadline yesterday. Michael Cohen lied to Congress, but the way he says it's not the way he says that he lied it because he wanted to fit what he perceived to be Trump's public messaging about not having business interests in Russia. And he lied about a Trump Tower deal that ultimately never got off the ground. Michael Flynn, I've talked about. So it's like, and Michael Flynn's conversations with the Russian ambassador that he was convicted of lying about, all those calls are wiretapped. So that's the reason we know about them. And right. Did those wiretaps lead to any discovery of any kind of illicit scheme between Trump and Russia for Flynn to lie about? No. So it's like you can say all these things like about, yes, people have lied. But then if you look at the actual consequence of what they led to and what they are, they're nothing. And then all these 37 indictments, they're for process crimes. In the case of Manafort, the only Trump figure to face serious prison time, it's for financial crimes that have nothing to do with Trump, Russia, or the election. It never would have been charged if not for the election. And then you have the indictment of the Russian troll farm workers who put out some stupid clickbait that was compared to Pearl Harbor and 9/11. And then you have the indictment of Russian military intelligence officers. And whether or not you believe the emails were leaked or hacked, the point is there's no evidence and no assertion by Mueller that the theft of those emails had anything to do with the Trump campaign. So we're left with really, yes, some indictments. But in terms of the substance of this issue, which is whether or not there's a conspiracy between Trump and Russia, we arrive at zero.